What about
you?
I'm
calling you from the 1930s over here.
Okay, well, I'm not sure what year I'm in, but...
I'm guessing. I don't really know.
No, that's older than the 1930s.
1920s, maybe.
Yeah, that's more like the 20s. Oh, you hung up on me.
Oh, sorry. You told me I was wrong.
No, no.
Okay, so today we are trying something new. We're going to check out the Edmonton Telephone Historical Society, which is located in the Prince of Wales Armoury in Edmonton. And I'm hanging out with my dad today. We both are he's former telecommunications industry professionals, so this is going to be pretty exciting, I think. Going to go check this out, assuming it's open. It's kind of, according to the internet, it's open, but it's like by donation only, and we're going to just go try to see if we can get in.
Coming in to visit the museums. Thank you. All righty.
So we've learned that in addition to the Telephone Historical Museum in this building, there's also a military museum. So we're going to check out both.
The number that you wanted, and then it would create the connection, and off you'd go. So when I first began in the phone biz, we went from this to this. That's the 233. There's no number to dial.
Is it on the handset?
What?
On the handset? No, like where are you? On the one that you're holding up to your ear?
I know. Let's see what happens. It's not working.
On the handset on your that's up to your ear.
Oh, right. I forgot about where that was. I forgot about these phones. Oh, there it is now. See,
oh, now it's ringing.
Oh, you have to pick up a phone over there, Sarah.
Which one do I pick up?
Whichever one's ringing.
Oh, it's this.
Oh, it's the one there.
Hello.
It works. We just went through a call. There, see?
So this is what they had when you first started?
Yep. When I first started, this is what we had. That's exactly what we had. That's the technology we had when I first began.
In 1980.
Thank you. Have you never been in a phone booth?
Well, I have. I didn't know this one. She could. Well, turn the light on.
Yes, it does. That's where you change into your Superman costume.
Or I'm Maxwell Smart.
That's right.
I go into chaos.
That's right, and you drop. And you drop down.
Push. Oh, I see. You're supposed to...
Oh, yeah. See? Showing you the sound waves.
Our sound waves.
Hello.
Did it work?
Of course.
Oh,
these in my office. I used to have tons of these in my office. What's the year? 1981. We should look us up. Look here. Here you are, looking yourself up.
Oh, here we are.
Here we are.
Is that us? Is that our address?
201-15-107 45th Avenue? Yes.
Is that us?
Hang on.
Okay, so we just came out of the Telephone Historical Museum, which is actually kind of cool. Like, I recommend going to check it out. It's admission by donation, and they've got, I think they're open Tuesday to Friday, 9 to 3. Close Mondays, weekends, and holidays. But it's pretty cool, and they had a little film that was 25 minutes long that was an interesting historical relic, if nothing else. It was from the early 90s, so it was give you a lot of historical context prior to then, but then nothing, obviously, in the last 30 years or so. So, but very cool, good way to spend, like, an hour. I think now we're going to go check out the Loyal Edmonton Regiment Museum, which is just down the hall.
Was a famous trumpet man from old Chicago way. He had a boogie style that no one else could play. He was the top man at his craft. But then his number came up and he was gone with the draft. He's in the army now, a blowing reveille. He's the boogie-woogie bugle boy of Company B. They made him blow a bugle for his Uncle Sam. It really brought him down because he couldn't jam. The captain seemed to understand. Because the next day the cap went out and drafted a band. And now the company jumps when he plays reveille. He's the boogie-woogie bugle boy of Company B. A toot, a toot, a toot-de-lad, a toot. He blows it eight to the bar. In boogie rhythm, he can't blow a note unless the bass and guitar is playing with him. He makes a company jump when he plays reveille. He's the boogie-woogie bugle boy of Company B. He was a boogie-woogie bugle boy of Company B. And when he plays boogie-woogie bugle, he was busy as a bzzz bee. And when he plays, he makes the company jump a to the bar. He's a boogie-woogie bugle boy of Company B. Do-do-do-do-da-da, do-da-da, do-do-do-do. He blows it a to the bar. He can't blow a note if the bass and guitar isn't with him. And the company jumps when he plays reveille. He's a boogie-woogie bugle boy of Company B.
Every night, and wakes them up the same way in the early bright. They clap their hands and stamp their feet, because they know how he plays when someone gives him a beat. He really breaks it up when he plays reveille. He's the boogie-woogie bugle boy of Company B.
Okay, so we're leaving the Armouries now, after checking out the Telephone Historical Museum and the Regimental Military Museum, which were both pretty cool, both admission by donation. There was pretty much nobody there, so lots of room to check things out by yourself. Recommend it.